Hey folks, today I wanted to show you a new synthesizer, or better, a new preset I created inside Bitwig Studio. And at first I want to show you how it sounds. Pretty mysterious. And I wanted to give you a small guide through the device and how I created it. At heart, this device is pretty simple. So we have different layers here, and each layer represents one note on the keyboard. When we press one key on the keyboard, only one layer becomes active. So for instance, when I press C2, only this layer becomes active. When we press another key, another layer becomes active. So every layer is the same layout, the same chain, but I show you one layer, how it looks. Inside this layer, we have a note filter, so we filter out each note, and we only let the note we pressed through. So in this case, it's C2. It's 38, 38, and this we have a different key, so each layer is one note. After the note filter, we have an voice chain container, and I created this to deactivate basically the whole voice when there is no key pressed. So when I press C2, this chain becomes active. And when the sound fades out, it becomes inactive again, basically just to save CPU power. And how quickly this deactivates is basically defined by the amplitude envelope here. So when we make a faster release time, the voice becomes inactive pretty fast. The voice itself is created by a DC offset device, which makes use of an LFO with a sine wave, and we can morph this into a sawtooth via this knobs here in the front panel. As you can see, we can change the shape amount and how fast the shape changes. And this creates pretty interesting soundscapes. So after this DC offset device or the oscillator itself, we have a resonator bank tuned to each octave of C, and the key track is enabled. So when we press another key, the resonator bank is changing the offset to the notes. And we have also a lot of randomization here going on, and you can also change this in the front panel here. Via G rate and Q rate, and you can basically define how much and how fast the gain changes, as you can see here, and how big the Q is and the rate it changes, as you can see here. And yeah, that's pretty much it for one voice. And that's duplicated to each voice or each note. And when you press different notes, each layer becomes active and has a different seed of randomization. And this creates interesting voices. We have, of course, also an FX chain here, which has a stereo delay, or more like a stereo reverb on each channel, left and right, with slightly different randomizations. So we have a nice stereo image. And you can also change this here in the front panel via the ref mix time and randomization rate parameters. And you can of course apply how much you want to randomize the reverb time. Yeah, and that's pretty much it. I think it sounds nice, and it's not heavy on the CPU. And yeah, it's of course free to download in my GitHub repository. And yeah, leave me a comment if you like it or if you have questions. And yeah, until next time, see you and bye.